reminisce, I reminisce. Yeah.
Hey everybody, it's your girl Kenlo, back at it again with a special guest. I have here Siraj.
Siraj, aka Raji, just saying, talented artist from Philadelphia.
Oh, Siraj, tell us how you got started with the art.
Basically, like a year ago, I was at a job, got tired of it. I went to like a couple of training programs, different things like that. And I just quit it, you know? It wasn't my fault. It was just like, you know, I just wanted to do what I love to do and my passion and art and different things like that. So 2015, yeah, I used to watch like a lot of videos on YouTube and always wanted to have, you know, my personal art. So I just did it and I liked it. In March, somebody wanted custom artwork, so I did that. And then from March to like October, November, I think that's like 8 months, I sold like 70 paintings. You know, just staying consistent, just keep grinding. And then it just been history ever since. So then that's October, November, been in a magazine, you know, my first time in a magazine, two page, full spread. Yo Gotti show love to me, PNB Rock show love to me, Young Jeezy show love to me, a couple other big artists, you know, that's from Philly and from LA and other big places, they've been really, you know, showing love to me, you know, congratulating me on my success so far. It's going on my second year, so like, I'm really good, you know, happy.
So tell us how you keep up with your consistency and like how you do paint every day.
Basically, you know, I have the love for it for myself. So like everything that I do, I wanted to do it for myself. So like when I did the clothing thing, like I wanted to do it for myself. Then people just branched onto it. Like, oh, one day when I did the paintings, you see how I did it for myself, and then people just wanted it. So it just started off like that. But like, being consistent, you know, it's just doing it every day. Just you gotta love it and just do it every day. You know, the money, you know, it's gonna come. Like you just gotta have that passion to do it every day. That's all.
So aside from graffiti, who other art are you into?
Fine art, you know, I do a little bit of graphic arts. I'm starting to get into that, like illustrations, different things. I'm trying to do little cartoons here and there. But basically, it's just graffiti, abstract, and like fine art, yeah. But the way how I make my art is very like difficult, but it's easy to like approach it and see it. But it's very like complex, because it's like I can use all of them in one, but it might not look like it like that. But you can get the figuration, like I don't know, it's just, that shit hot, man. It's crazy. Like,
so tell me about your artwork right here, and how did you get the inspiration?
Well, with this piece right here, this is when I first started, you know, doing good. You know, young boy, do your little bad stuff. Then once you start getting your hair right, you know. So this is basically me, and this is my gift right here. And this, like, this my name means Siraj. So Siraj means light. So that's why I like a lot of bright colors and different things like that. And right here is like a lot of abstract, meaning that the distractions and bad things that, you know, as a young boy you go through and stuff like that. So you know, this escaping away, and the brighter things coming, you know, to my future. So it's like me just opening up my gift and things like that. So this is where this piece comes from.
Tell us about the your other piece of work
that you with this piece right here. I'm doing a collection of probably doing like 50 of these heart pieces, so it's really a R and a 5.
Oh,
so
okay.
My name, you know, my little nickname is Raji, so, and then the 5 is my favorite number, so I put that together, and I don't know, everybody just,
yeah, like,
you know, love it, so.
So
I did a painting at Love Park one day, and I wasn't supposed to, but I did it anyway. The next week I did a painting, and the cops saying I can't do it, blah, blah, blah. So I'm like, all right. I don't want to just go home, so I called up some recreation centers. They were saying no. Then my old head at Palumbo, he was like, you can come down here. So I came down there doing my art. People walking past, they like, oh my God, I want it. I'm like, damn, I'm like, okay, all right. But not knowing that some art shows down the street, so everybody coming from here, coming straight down where I was doing the art, and they could see it. So like three people wanted to buy it, right? But one person came through, so he was like, yo, I want that, I'm gonna be right back. So I gave my number, so I think he gonna call me probably like next week, or he called me that same, probably like 5 minutes, was like, yo, you done a piece? I'm like, yeah, I've done it. So he came back, bought it. My intention was to just to do it for the love of it, and you know, see how God works, and you know, it's just a blessing like that. So this is where the heart, and I did the little heart thing on there, not knowing it was just, you know, how I came about.
So the colors that you incorporate, does that only just come from your name, or do you just get inspired by the colors that you
incorporate? I'm really big on color, so sometimes I get inspired, like if I see a tree, I don't know, might got some, I don't know, purple speckles, it might not, but I might imagine it having on there, so yeah. So it just, but usually I just use a lot of bright colors, you know, because it represents my name, so when I tell people, you know, they understand it and stuff like that. But then, like, you know, it just mean happy, and, you know, somebody might be sad one day, they might see my art and get inspired and happy, and, you know, so that's why I use a lot of bright colors. But I have a lot of contrast colors to make me feel the same way, too.
As we know, you are a Muslim young man. So, are you making more art for, you know,
incorporating
your religion inside of your art more?
Yeah, because I think that this is what grounds me. You know, I'm not gonna say I'm not gonna go full inside in it, but I'm not gonna say that I'm not gonna do it because it's who I am. So I like to incorporate it inside my art, just like I incorporate anything else I do inside. So it just all makes sense. So when you know who I am, like, you know, okay, he's Muslim, he an artist, he an entrepreneur, he a hustler, grinder. Young boy doing his thing, positive, so it just all adds up to one place.
So tell us about some of the big successes you had and the others that you can have.
Some of the other successes I had, my dad, Jamaluddin, became a famous jazz musician, bass guitar player. He introduced me to James Dupree. If you don't know who that is, go look him up. He's a famous artist, you know, from Philadelphia. And I introduced with him. He liked my artwork, and he liked my artwork, and, you know, how I proceeded to go about it and stuff like that. This was like when I first started out. So shout out to him. I met him. Who else? I met Monet Davis, you know, got some art to her family, her and her brother Brian, so shout out to him and her. She doing her thing out here, man, so shout out to Monet Davis and her family. Shout out to Celine, man, my man from Wimp School, Pop School, that's my big bro, man, I'm under his wing, you know, that's my mentor, so we definitely grinding and we working out here. I feel really good, you know, I put a lot of hard work, dedication, time into it, you know, the things that people don't see, but it's all well worth it, you know, at the end of the time, so, you know, I'm just going to keep grinding and keep showing love and support to other people that's coming up to me.
Okay, so with your art, do you plan on going, like, international, like, really, really big with your art?
That's the goal, you know, I got a lot of people that's saying, like, overseas, like, Europe, London, Indonesia that really want my art and support me, but they can't really get it because you know it's like it's so far. But you know, one day I promise, you know, I'm going over there soon. You know, I've actually been to Europe, you know, when my dad was on tour. You know, I actually been there, you know, for like 3 weeks or something like that. My dad was on tour and it was an amazing time. The people over there love Philly people, you know, they kept calling me Will Smith. I was like, oh man, you know, so it's feeling really good, you know. That's all.
Okay. So aside from Philly, like, what do you plan on living to get your art out there first?
I'm moving out of my house, you know. I'm 21 though, so I'm still good, you know, maybe one more year. But you know, other than that, you know, I got a couple options that's going to be in the long run, maybe in LA, maybe Miami. You know, when the time comes, you know, I'll think over it more. But basically, I want to have like a studio type of house type of thing, you know. So that's definitely the goal right there.
Okay. So I know you mentioned LA before, so what about LA and the trees, especially with the art? Because I know a lot of art goes down there.
I love it. I mean, well, Philly, you get a couple connections, but LA, you get to see everybody running or so. Like, yo, what's up, Raj? Yo, what's up? Somebody might see Future, Drake, somebody, you know. So and other artists that do the same thing as you do, you know. And it's good to, you know, let other people see you and you see them, you know. And the connection is better, you know what I'm saying. But being a Philly boy, you gotta make your way into these connections here, based. You know, and just grow from it, and you know, when it's time to take off, you take off. So this is Lupatex right here. It's one of the great brands that I use, Heavy Body. So this is a Heavy Body, a lot of bright colors, saturated colors. This is a Soft Body right here that I don't use that much, but it's good if you want to use it. This is the basic, so that's like the student grade volume. A lot of people use. This is Molotov, Montana, 84. Great markers that I like to use. They just released this new water base. So I use a lot of those. Cool markers. A lot of colors right there. Big all the canvases, you know. We got canvases, wooden panels, or you can use anything you can. do whatever you want. But the biggest canvas that I did was, the biggest canvas that I did was probably like 48 by 30 or 36, something like that. That was the biggest one that I sold for sale. This is Montana Gold, this is what I use, this is what I love to use. Low pressure, great. This is the low pressure. This is the low pressure. My gold low pressure, and the black is higher pressure.
Higher pressure. Okay. But do your thing. Alright, she gonna kill me. Get it against me. Kill me. Show. We got my boy Rodney. That right there is Brad.
That's hot. Now I suppose you
the little black boy
and you know.
Alright, so wait.
I'm recording y'all too. Do the dad. I'll be the digital dad. I'm looking bigger than the best. I serve the base. No, yo, after that, we'll just throw it early now. Wicked tunes. Tell you what I'm gonna do when they reminisce over you, my God.